just Yamaguchi, complete and total domination.
Yamaguchi comes racing across the cage, only to touch gloves though for a second time. A low crouch, she's got high guard. Jenny Huang, all action, all movement. That left hand always just pokes out like a piston, long before it makes an attempt to land anything. It's all just tentative stuff at the moment, first half minute of the opening round. 3 5-minute rounds to come.
When Jenny Huang challenged for the belt, she learned a lot about her ability to strike and absorb shots. So she really wants to take that learning that she had from her title fight and transition into here. And she's really made a lot of adjustments in her boxing and her Muay Thai as far as closing the distance, getting close, and then utilizing that judo.
I don't know if you're seeing a difference in Mei Yamaguchi in the structure there, her arm. She looks ripped, more ripped than I've seen her before. And I think Jenny Huang a little bit tentative about being hit by that big right hand. We've all seen the damage it can do, and it was thrown there. And Jenny Huang doesn't want to get too close to that. Lands a left of her own though, the girl from Chinese Taipei. It was a nice little shot. Lots of movement between these two, exchanging kicks back and forwards, round and round.
You spoke of the physique of Mei Yamaguchi, and she did add a little bit more strength and conditioning to her pre-fight preparation this time around, because she felt she lacked a little bit of the explosiveness in her past contests.
Just got caught with a couple of right hands that weren't particularly hard-hitting from Jenny Huang, but she did leave herself exposed there, the Japanese woman. Oh! Was she caught? A little bit of a slip, off balance?
I think it's a little bit of both. A little bit of a leg kick right as she was trying to lunge out, and the leg got taken out from under her just a bit.
Concentration on both faces. Mei catches the leg and then gets to grips, and the knee up to the body. Right hand, a couple of short right hands from Mei Yamaguchi to the left side of Jenny Huang's jaw.
Very calculating fight so far. You can see each fighter is trying to absorb the shot that's taken and then just sort of figure out exactly what's going on and see if they can make adjustments midstream.
Let's see what that ends. Oh, good right hand from Mei Yamaguchi. She takes two or three punches back, but the crispness of that right hand was very eye-catching indeed. Now she digs into the body with that right hand as she presses Jenny Huang up against the cage.
You can see the momentum of that right hand actually takes her, and she has to take a few steps forward as she throws that big right hand. That's how much power is put behind that overhand right.
And there you can see that low angle that we've seen in other fights, employed this time by Mei Yamaguchi to press her opponent against the cage so that there's no escape. She's almost 45 degrees there.
This is where Jenny excels. She's stopping the takedown, and she's utilized that judo background more defensively. You can see that base is so agile and stable as she's avoiding the takedown of Mei Yamaguchi.
Mei kneeing to the thigh. She's done that a few times. There it is again, the inside of the left thigh there. Goes for the single leg, and down Jenny Huang goes.
Single leg takedown from Mei Yamaguchi to end up on top. But we've seen it before. Jenny Huang is really dangerous off her back. Immediately you can see her starting to trap those arms, you know, locking that right arm down there as she's starting to hit her guard up. You can see her trying to threaten an arm bar right there.
Don't grab the fence.
Olivier Cost asking them not to grab the fence. He's talking to Jenny Huang. Final minute of the first round here. Mei Yamaguchi against Jenny Huang in Yangon, Myanmar. The crowd, noisy as they have been all evening. There's more noise to come from them, I can assure you, as the night goes on, but there's plenty for them to be interested in here.
I like how active Jenny is off her back. She's not just sitting there holding her in closed guard. You can see her putting the feet on the hips, constantly throwing up that right leg as she's trying to get that right leg up high onto the back of Mei Yamaguchi, trapping the arm with the left hand, and then she's gonna look to throw that left leg up over the neck of Mei Yamaguchi and possibly look for an armbar.
Meanwhile, whenever Mei Yamaguchi can free a left or a right hand, she quickly throws it towards Jenny Huang's head. And she's done that pretty effectively. Final 10 seconds, and listen to the crowd as they realize that this first round is coming to an end. The anticipation of 10 more minutes. Thrilling for everyone. 5 minutes down. How do you see that one, Mitch? It was furious action. There was no respite at all.
A lot of back and forth action, but you can see that May, there's that leg kick. There was a possible stumble. Nice clinch position here, engaged in the knee. The clinching was able to get Mei Yamaguchi into a position to secure the takedown. See how she lunges forward in that right hand? That's how much force and velocity is behind that right hand that Mei Yamaguchi throws. The first round, I'm going to give a slight edge to Mei Yamaguchi. She was able to control the top position, deliver ground and pound, and really control the significant striking when they were on the feet.
Tell you what, though, great work by our cameraman there and our guys working the instant replay, because you saw four consecutive punches to the head landing from Jenny Huang. So under pressure and often going backwards, she is able to land. And this huge crowd, along with the judges, will be watching this very, very closely as the next 10 minutes unfold.
Ready?
If this one goes the distance, it's going to be mighty close. Second round, two strong women with power. Spinning back kick from Jenny Huang, but
I like how she set that up, Steve. Faked the roundhouse, came around with the left for a hook. It's like a spinning crescent kick. Well done.
I always think when you do that spinning back kick business, you do sometimes expose yourself a little bit, and she did take one or two blows as a result.
The creativity and the adjustments in the striking are there from Jenny Huang. She looks to be utilizing a lot more footwork, not standing stationary, consistently throwing out that jab, and just hit attacking from awkward angles. Big takedown, and Jenny Huang jumped guard there, possibly threatened a guillotine, but she looks like she's a bit high. Mei Yamaguchi is easily able to throw that off.
That's the creativeness that we've come to expect from Jenny Huang. She doesn't always do the orthodox thing. She's very imaginative in her moves.
Overhand right there again from Mei Yamaguchi. That seems to be her bread and butter when it comes to the striking game.
Yeah, from this position, Mei will, if she can get in close, look to free her hands up, land those punches. The ground and pound is something she's enjoyed already in this contest. And she'll look to throw in those forearms and elbows as well.
You know, with our judging criteria, it's not necessarily the person on top that is winning the round. If you're on bottom and you're threatening submissions and also striking from the bottom, you can actually edge out a lot of the categories from the bottom.
The upkick there is a particularly dangerous move for the person standing up to receive. You should be wary of the go-go platter as well, Mei Yamaguchi.
But I think the entire atomweight division is wary of the go-go plata. Lady Go-Go can throw it up so easily. Nice little half-guard adjustment to prevent Mei Yamaguchi from sliding fully past her guard there.
Right above us here at cage side, and three times now Mei Yamaguchi has picked up Jenny Huang and thrashed her back towards the canvas, and the crowd making noise as she does it. She digs in with right hands as well. Gets her right hand around the throat of Jenny Huang, but doesn't look as if she can do too much damage from there, Mitch.
Really? She's in danger of getting past. Yup. Mei Yamaguchi was able to use those strikes to the body to pass the guard. But nice adjustment again from Jenny Huang to avoid the dangerous mount position and to stay in half guard.
Not a comfortable time for her, though, in terms of blows to the face. The knees come close once or twice, but it's the left and the right, and that was a superb left punch going downwards. She just thought about drawing back that knee again. She hasn't quite landed it yet, but it's in her mind, and that knee to the head of her grounded opponent is particularly dangerous.
A lot of sneaky strikes coming through from Mei Yamaguchi on top. You can see her not really going for a lot of big, powerful powerful strikes, but a lot of short, crisp punches that are sliding right past the defense of Jenny Huang. Now she's in full mount position. This is a bad spot for Jenny to be, and she's got to create movement. She's got to move those hips just a little bit to get back into half guard.
Arms around the neck, Mitch, to pull her in, but both arms free, and Mei can pound with left and right here.
Yeah, but she's negating the ability for Mei Yamaguchi to posture up like she's doing right now and create that space to drop those punches.
She's got her back. Arms underneath the chin. Watch out for the rear naked choke. She hadn't got the second arm on it, and Jenny did well, but the other arm goes round now. This is very dangerous. It could come the tap. Has it? Yes, it is. Mei Yamaguchi has won this one in the second round with just over a minute left. Rear naked choke, and she's back, Mitch, on the title trail.
That's a huge win for Miss Yamaguchi to get a rear naked choke off the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu specialist, Jenny Huang. Huge win here in Yangon. Rear naked choke, Mei Yamaguchi.
What an athlete this 34-year-old woman is. To be fair, she just had the edge in about every aspect of the fight up until this point. Took a right hand there.
Look at this. Here's where Jenny Huang attempted the jump guard into a guillotine, but once it got to the ground, Mei Yamaguchi was able to control the positions. And you can see Jenny Huang wasn't even able to fight the position. That's how deep this choke was. Once she came under the neck, right here, you can just see her lock it up and grab the bicep, and Jenny Huang is forced to tap. Brilliant.
Yamaguchi improves her record to 16-10-1 with the official decision. Anthony Suntai.
To present the medal for this fight, we have Mr. Aung Koko, Deputy Managing Director of First National Insurance. Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Coste calls a hold to this battle at 4 minutes of round number two. For your winner, by submission, via rear naked choke, Mei Yamaguchi!
Two really capable women. It was a shame that only one of them would come away with a win tonight. It turns out that it was the Japanese woman, Mei Yamaguchi. She does it again.
Ready? Of intensity, Yamaguchi this week around the hotel, in media interviews, in open workouts. I've never seen Mei look more focused, more determined. She wants that crack, that rematch for the title in 2018. And she's got to get past Gina Inyong, and Inyong's got one big prime weapon, Mitch. That's the straight right cross of the Filipino.
Yeah, she has a beautiful straight right hand that comes off like a trip hammer. Extremely powerful, but also very fast. And you can see Mei Yamaguchi likes to come in close. She likes to close the distance. She's a point fighter.
Clinching up for the first time, it's Inyong who presses Mei against the cage. Yamaguchi has never lost a rematch. She is 3-0-1 in rematches. Since she worked on her boxing, on her grappling in preparation for this one. Inyong says she's got to watch out for Yamaguchi's ground game, has to be very vigilant on the submissions. Says she exposes Mei Yamaguchi in the striking. And says, I believe Mei is open to my right cross. Yamaguchi predicted a second round choke win. Inyong didn't pick a round, but said it'll be either a TKO or a decision. Nice corking knees here from Gina Inyong.
But look at the position, Michael, that she's holding her in. She's got double underhooks on Mei Yamaguchi. She's pressing her up against the cage, and there's nowhere for her to go. Now she's trying to spin off, but look at the pressure that Inyong is applying up against the cage. She's landing these knees. I think these knees are starting to bother her, Michael.
Having competed only 2 weeks ago, you've got to ask the question, should this one get to the third round, how will the gas tank of Gina Inyong hold up tonight?
Oh, I think it's going to hold up tremendously well, because she trains out there at altitude with Team Lakai in Baguio City, Philippines. So the entire team has a huge gas tank, and stamina is rarely a problem.
With the champion here, alongside Mitch Angela Lee, does that spur on Mei Yamaguchi that little bit more, knowing Angela's right here, a few feet away, watching her?
It's got to, because you can get inside the mind of your opponent if you put on a tremendous display of athletic ability. With one big punch, with one big kick, you can easily secure yourself that rematch. Nice little pull guard there.
A
there. She didn't want to get too entangled in that, but she did a butterfly sweep. Beautifully done by Yamaguchi.
Exactly where Yamaguchi wants to be. Top position with Gina Inion on her back. And you see Inion wisely closing the guard, trying to control the posture. Doesn't want the ground and pound coming through here from Mei Yamaguchi.
Inion's trying to trap that arm and throw up an arm bar. She's trying to pivot her hips out, but you can see Yamaguchi's with her hips.
Powerful elbows off the left arm from Yamaguchi.
Young tries to create a little bit of space by pushing the hips away, but Yamaguchi gets right back on top.
We are seeing two halves of the contest so far. On the feet, it was Gina Inion. On the ground, it's Mei Yamaguchi in control.
Watch out ahead. Time.
Illegal up kick there from Gina Inion, Mitch.
Yeah, we had two knees down. We had over 3 points with a full weight on the knees. Rich, how did you see that one?
An accidental kick. She kind of realized what she did after she did it. A little bit of an apology. I don't think they're going to take full time out here. They'll probably get the back to action real quick.
It looks like the knee, possibly she was kicking the body, but it slid up to the chin. Maybe it was inadvertent, most likely completely inadvertent.
And there's the champion, Angela Lee, as we said here, cage side, recovering from a car accident a few weeks ago, which sidelined her for tonight. She was meant to face Mei Yamaguchi. The winner of this one will be the number one contender, we believe, in 2018 to take on Angela Lee. And here's the illegal up kick, Mitch.
Yeah, it looks like maybe just some of the toes caught her on the chin there. She was trying to kick her in the chest, but maybe just some of the toes got her there in the chin.
Referee Olivier Coase gets us back underway here in the first round. Now, on the feet is where Conviction Gina Inion has been impressive so far. She's got to try and avoid going to ground with Mei Yamaguchi.
But we got to keep in mind that Mei Yamaguchi's got a third-degree black belt in karate, so she's got a nice, you can see it, she's got that nice wide stance. Her hands are low, perfectly placed kind of for that big right hand of Inion.
A karateka in the stand-up versus a six-time national wushu champion. You've got to watch out for the right hand, the straight right hand of Junior Inion. Inion trying to press Yamaguchi against the cage here. Under a minute remaining in the opening round.
You can just see how strong Inion is. There's no place for Yamaguchi to go except right there. She realizes that's her biggest weapon in that clinch is to pull guard. Now she's got the butterfly hooks, so maybe we can look for that same sweep she did earlier.
And Inion did say she might get a takedown by a ground and pound. Gotta be careful of them.
There's that same sweep she has. She likes to pull guard, get the butterfly hooks in, elevate the hips of Inion, and end up on top.
Gina Inion on her back. One butterfly hook on the left leg. Now feet on hips, now throws the legs up, maybe hoping to lock up the arm of Yamaguchi. Gina Inion hunts for a submission in the final stages, but won't get it. Good round, we go to the town.
There's the clinch, nice knee again. Yamaguchi was able to pull guard. Here you can see the butterfly hooks go in. She elevates that right side, ends up with a beautifully timed sweep. She did it twice in that round. That's got a score in a variety of categories. You can see her do it again right here. She has the overhook on one side, elevates the hips, butterfly sweep to end up on top. Interesting round. Rich, break that one down for him.
I'm going to focus on the ground control for this particular scoring. This isn't indicative of the entire match this first round, but Mei Yamaguchi's definitely winning the ground control. She's taking the fight to the ground. I'm not scoring takedowns on that, but she's able to reverse, land some ground and pounds in the top position, which definitely outscores the damage that Gina is doing from the clinch position with the knee. So at this point in time, I have Mei ahead on the scorecards. Slightly.
All right, fighters ready?
Capacity crowd inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium for one championship, another sellout. And wherever you're watching, 128 countries, potentially over 1 billion people worldwide. We hope you're enjoying all the action. So much at stake here for Mei Yamaguchi and Gina Inion. could determine the number one contender for the Atomweight title in 2018. Ineong two-punch combination. Little fakes and feints there from Yamaguchi as she edges forward. High on the balls of her feet, that wider karate stance. Shoots in for a single leg, a low single, wraps the hands around the back of the knee, switches to a
nice takedown from Yamaguchi. I was expecting her to punch into the clinch and probably jump guard again, but she went in and attacked the single leg, and now she's sitting in the half guard of Ineong.
Something you don't see a lot outside of Japan these days, the single leg takedown. It's always the Kazushi Sakuraba special, of course, the low single leg. Saw Yamaguchi switch from a single to a double, now inside the half guard position. She can do some damage from here, Mei Yamaguchi. What should Gina Ineong be looking to do here, Mitch?
Gina Ineong's got to create a little bit of space. Right now, see how she's got her hand, that left hand on the chin there? She can start to frame away and create a little bit of space, but she spins underneath, gets that underhook on that side. Now she can create a little bit more space, but you can see Yamaguchi trying to flatten Ineong out onto the mat, now delivering a little bit of ground and pound. You can see how Ineong's trying to dive under and attack that leg to possibly swivel up and create a little bit of a transition here. She's trying to suck that leg in. She may be able to reverse the position here.
Latching onto a single leg here is Gina Ineong.
Heavy sprawl from Yamaguchi keeps the legs as far away from Ineong as possible, but she has an outside trip.
Ineong almost back to her feet, now looking for top position. Can she keep pulling her back? No, Mei gets top position.
She's using her butterfly hooks very well, how she takes the insides of her shin and kind of sticks her feet underneath the legs of Ineong, and that's given her that control where she's able to reverse the positions.
We said earlier that Mei Yamaguchi is undefeated in rematches, 3-0-1. Well, this is Gina Ineong's first ever rematch. Full mount coming here, yes, from Mei Yamaguchi. Dominant position from the Japanese athlete. Can she take the back here?
Gotta be careful, bridging out. She extended that arm up. She gets to get back on. But again, the butterfly hook is able to control the position of Ineong.
Some seesawing on the ground. Yamaguchi top position once more. Works the right hand to the body, then to the head. What should Gina be looking to do from here, Mitch?
Here you can see she has her left leg across the stomach of Yamaguchi, so she's trying to create a little bit more space, but she also doesn't want to let Yamaguchi do any more ground and pound, because that seems to be bothering her a little bit, so she's pulling her head in as well. So here she can probably dive under and possibly sweep as well, but I think Yamaguchi's onto that, so she's got to create some space and start to scramble.
Ineong. Training with the likes of Edward Falayan, Honorio Benario, Kevin Bellingon, star-studded team at Lakai. Side control now for Mei Yamaguchi. She did predict, once again, a second round submission by a choke.
Here's an Americana attempt right here. You can see the shoulder lock, but she's trying to lock into that position right there. But Ineong does the right thing, but she's got to turn the other way and start moving.
Yamaguchi looking to go to work on that far arm again.
Back to finish.
We're going to pin the right arm though. 1 minute left. Amethyst tries to the press basket there of Gina Ineong.
Again, another Americana attempt. She's here trying to pin down the left arm of Ineong.
Neon Belly, more aggressive position. Now it's the full mount. No, she switches to the opposite side of the body. Head arm choke coming here. Mei Yamaguchi turning. Can she find it? Can she step out? Gina Ineong. 30 seconds to go in the round. Gina holding on. Mei applies the vice like pressure. Squeezing. Turning. 20 seconds now. It's survival for Gina Ineong. It looks like Gina Ineong is going to survive the round.
Interesting defense from Gina Ineong for that arm triangle. She was pushing with her right hand on her left hand to create a little bit of space so the choke couldn't get in deep. Not the best technique as far as defending your arm triangle, but it worked.
Mitch, I've got to ask the question again. She's taken some punishment via ground and pound in that second round. How do you think the gas tank is holding up on Gina Inyong, who once again competed only 2 weeks ago?
Just a few weeks ago, she was in Manila, and she had a really good contest. But we gotta wonder, I mean, I just think we're seeing the ground superiority play out here, and Yamaguchi's able to control this match on the ground. Rich, do you see it the same way?
Yeah, absolutely. You know, Mei's doing a great job of controlling on the ground. I'll be honest, I was a little disappointed in her ability to actually accumulate damage as that round went on, until I saw a couple of those knees at about a minute left, and then she landed that arm triangle. I actually scored her in a near submission for that, which puts her even higher on the scoring category. So in the last minute of that round, she really just extended her lead significantly.
Sellout crowd inside the Singapore indoor arena. Third and final round. It is still anyone's bout for the taking here between Gina Inyong and Mei Yamaguchi. Big overhand right to open up the round from Mei. Want to see Inyong get her right hand off. Got a big reach advantage here. Some 5 centimeters taller is Gina Inyong. Can she keep the contest standing?
That right hand is her best weapon. You see the way she jumped into that right hand and then slid right out of the way? Goes and dives in for a double leg. Nice wizard defense there from Inyong.
Into the bread basket. Look at that. Pull guard again there, perhaps, was Mei Yamaguchi trying to get Inyong to come down to the ground. And Inyong does a little pirouette and gets out of trouble.
Inyong still looks light on her feet. She's still moving around really well, nice and relaxed. I don't think the gas tank is her problem. I just think the ground superiority and her being controlled on the ground is the biggest flaw in this possible contest.
Leads him with a stiff jab there, does Yamaguchi.
She's like a fencer, Michael. She just jumps in, spears with a punch, and then gets right out of the way.
Fakes the right hand, goes for a head kick, didn't have the torque behind it. And takes an accidental groin strike, does Yamaguchi. She'll get some recovery time here. And Olivia Costa will send Gina Inyong to a neutral part of the cage. Okay, Mitch, let's play coach for a moment. We've only the third round remaining. If you're in the corner of Mei Yamaguchi, what are you telling the Japanese athlete to do?
Right now, she's doing everything right. Now, we're finally starting to see in this third round, she's landing some superior striking ability. She's jumping in, she's landing some shots, she's getting out of the way, and you can see that when she does get into the clinch, that's where she's able to initiate her ground attacks. She's pulling guards, sweeping to get up on top.
What about Gina Inyong? Because as we said, Yamaguchi on the ground has been dominant. What does Gina need to do?
Gina's got to kind of go for broke in this case. She's really starting to get to put together some big strikes and to hurt Yamaguchi. She has to throw caution to the wind at these times. I'd like to see her with that lead push kick. A lot of these jumping side kicks, we're not seeing any of the lower body kicks.
You just get that feeling that Gina Inyong could land that power-laden right hand at any time, and she goes for it there.
But that's all she's doing. Strikes she's throwing occasionally with the hook. She's thrown like maybe 1 or 2 kicks the entire match.
Counter right hand there from Mei Yamaguchi, and Gina Inyong floats back to center cage.
You can see with the wide stance of Yamaguchi, that leg is prime. It's right there. It's a huge target for some leg kicks.
Although we saw Gina slow down with the use of the right hand in the second round, we can see her picking up again here in the third. She knows that's the prime weapon. She knows if she's going to knock out Yamaguchi tonight, it's going to be with either the straight right or the short overhand right.
You can see Mark Sangrio trying to get her animated, trying to keep her in this match. And these guys, they never have, the Lakai athletes never have a problem with gas. They have huge gas tanks, but she's got to go.
At the same time, Yamaguchi on her strikes has to make sure she doesn't overextend herself, because Inyong can counter and counter effectively. Yamaguchi looks for the inside thigh kick. Inyong fakes the right hand. 1 minute remains in the third and final round. There's the right hand from Gina Inyong. Just didn't have the starch behind it. The crowd want to see more of the right hand from Gina.
got that single leg, but good defense from Ian Young. Now she's got to fight the body lock. Oh, she's taken down, and she lands inside control.
Dominant position now for Mei Yamaguchi with 35 seconds remaining in this contest. The left hand goes to work for Mei Yamaguchi. This is where she's been so dominant. This is where she's had control every time it's gone to ground, Mitch.
Yeah, and you can just see that she's very, very comfortable in this position. But I'd like to see her possibly work for the finish. She's been so dominant in that position. She could really put a punctuation on this possibly number one contender bout and really secure her spot in the title hunt.
She's doing some punctuating with those knees. I'll tell you what, those right knees to the body and head of Gina Inion. Now knee on belly from Yamaguchi. My word, Mei Yamaguchi bringing it home strongly here. Pops her head up, pops it up. Two punch combination on the ground and pound from Yamaguchi. All over Gina Inion on the canvas. Yamaguchi just dominant here. Short elbows, right hands. Inion struggling to find her way back to her feet. Is Yamaguchi going to allow her up? Last chance here for Inion. Has she got one big salvo left? One big right hand perhaps from Gina. Mei edges forward. Had a static right hand range. There's an uppercut attempt there from Gina. Can she find a Hail Mary shot? Gina Inion. Final 10 seconds. If it's going to come, it's going to come now. Looking for a takedown again. Yamaguchi, single leg. And there it is. We go to the judges. A battle that could very well have determined the number one contender to face that woman, the Atomweight World Champion, Angela Lee. Wild white right hand there from Gina. Here's the grounded pound from Mei Yamaguchi. The knees, the hammer fist strikes. Good posture up there. Two punches landing. Who will secure it? Really was a contrast of styles in the stand-up. It went the way of Inion on the ground and went to Yamaguchi. Rich Franklin, let's get your thoughts on who you think won this one.
Mei Yamaguchi dominated every category of that match. You know, she was a bit more aggressive, and that picked up towards the end of the match. She was landing takedowns at the end. Great ground control. You can see it with the ground and pound. She had a near submission with the arm triangle. I scored her in damage. She was scoring high on every category and walked away with this fight.
Okay, to find out who won, let's go to Dominic Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we now turn to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this bout in favor of your winner by way of unanimous decision from the red corner, Mei Yamaguchi.
What a crowd on hand inside the Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia. Olivia Cost gets us underway. Mei Yamaguchi bounds out of her corner. She is in the blue and white. In the pink trunks is Jo Marie Torres. Can Torres give us another shock? Can she cause another upset?
Yamaguchi's got a pretty big height and reach disadvantage. I'd like to see how Jo Marie Torres utilizes that reach advantage by putting that jab out there. She seems a bit tentative right now. Nice little jab.
You must have heard you, Mitch. There's the jab down the center corridor from Jo Marie. Yamaguchi has said she would love a trilogy match with Angela Lee. Their first two matches were two of the all-time greatest. Jam to overhand right there from Yamaguchi, controlling Sensei Cage, the Karateka.
You see the boxing kind of coming out a little bit in Mei Yamaguchi. She hasn't really landed anything yet, but she's definitely thrown a lot. There's nice little overhand. That's what she's known for. That's what she dropped Angela Lee with. She has a beautifully timed overhand right. And Jo Marie Torres has got to be careful. She's got to keep that hand up nice and close to her chin, because if Mei Yamaguchi touches you, she will put you down.
Yamaguchi will use the traditional karate techniques, the yakuzuki, the chudansuki, the reverse punches to the midsection, the mawashi geti roundhouse kicks, the mai geti front kicks, the uchiro geti turning back kicks.
She switches to southpaw stance and now back to orthodox dismay. Jab to right hand, outside leg kick from Joe Marie Torres.
Very wide stance from Mei Yamaguchi. I'd like to see Torres start laying into that leg kick right there. She landed one, there's another one. That's good. She's got to keep going back to that. She can't let Mei Yamaguchi get settled and start to tee off on him.
Outside leg kick, Joe Marie. Yamaguchi catches the kicking leg on the front foot, the Japanese. Joe Marie tangles with her now. Up against the cage, 2:50 remaining, first round of three.
That tight body clinch there by Mei Yamaguchi. Torres is trying to swim that arm in, but she can't because that shoulder is so close to the body of Torres.
What a year it's been for the Philippines in 2018. They've been the standout nation in ONE Championship. Can you believe out of 8 male world champions, 5 of them are Filipino at the year's end? Incredible. And Jo Marie Torres has been leading the Filipina charge with some fantastic results.
Nice bridge, but she gives up her back in the process. It's a bad spot to be in with Mei Yamaguchi on your back. She's got that seatbelt, one hand over the head, and she's trying to dig those hooks in. Torres has got to start scrambling. They're still dry, so there's not a lot of sweat to start prying them apart to slip off of. You can see all the welts building up on Mei Yamaguchi's legs.
Those welts have come from the leg kicks early on of Jo Marie Torres. Good little knee there from Yamaguchi.
Yamaguchi's got that tight seatbelt. See how she's got one hand draped over the shoulder, one hand underneath the body there. That's gonna give her very tight grip. Good control of the body of Torres.
Very proud Japanese Mei Yamaguchi, a student of Japanese history and philosophy. Plays Japanese instruments as well.
Heavy sprawl from Torres, over from Yamaguchi. Nice, she was able to utilize the overhook whizzer, where she has the left arm over the shoulder of Torres, and she was able to shrug her off.
Where does Jo Marie go from here, Dragon?
She's trying to attack that single leg, so she's got to keep going after that single leg. She's got to pull that leg into her, take that right leg, but she chooses to let it go because you can see Yamaguchi starting to threaten the choke, and she's laying in those knees to her head. Jo Marie Torres has got to separate the grip. She's got to separate the grip right there over the head, and she's got to create a little bit of space. Look at that control from Yamaguchi. Ends up in side control, pins down the left arm. Now she's going to probably attack Kimura on one side.
The aggression we've come to know, we've come to love from Mei Yamaguchi, one of 3 Japanese athletes on tonight's card.
Changes it up to a possible Americana right there. It's a key lock, a shoulder lock on the right side there. She's cranking on it. It's a bad spot for Torres. Torres has got to keep her arms nice and tight to her body. It's almost Tyrannosaurus Rex-like. Keep the arms nice and tight.
The experience of Mei Yamaguchi shining through here at the moment. The former Jules champion. That knee not connecting to the jaw, just connecting under the arm of Jo Marie. Cuts the hip in again. Side control here for Yamaguchi. What a dominant way to end the round for VV Mei Yamaguchi.
We're talking about Mei Yamaguchi being a veteran. This is her 30th professional mixed martial arts match. She's been doing this for 11 years. There's a little bit of pawn out. Nice little overhand thrown by Torres. Torres came underneath with that hook. That was her best exchange. But then here's Yamaguchi laying in. And this is where the domination started to occur. On the ground, Yamaguchi is running away with it. Torres needs to make sure she stops the takedown. She's got to utilize those leg kicks, but she caught the leg kicks. Ladies and gentlemen, you can win a trip to a ONE Championship event by choosing the bout of the night. Let them know, Michael Civello.
Choose the bout of the night now on the ONE Super app. You can win an all-expenses-paid trip to a ONE Championship event. I tell you what, this is the hottest ticket in Kuala Lumpur as I glance around the mighty Axiata Arena. 2nd of 3 here.
And Yamaguchi's gonna try to keep Torres in front of her. You can see her, she's cutting the angle. As Torres starts to circle to the right, Yamaguchi's cutting those angles off. Torres needs to keep moving. She's gotta circle away from that power side, circle away from the right hand, and stay away from those kicks. See Torres start laying into those leg kicks again. Throw the hands, throw the leg kick, but that's also how she got taken down. Yamaguchi caught one of those leg kicks and drove into her.
Yamaguchi trying to find a home for her overhand right. The weapon that Angela Lee did not like very much. Good stiff jab there from Jo Marie.
Whenever Jo Marie Torres is throwing that jab, she's dropping her right hand down by her waist. She's got to be careful. Mei Yamaguchi has a beautiful step inside kick without any shuffle whatsoever. She can come up high with those high kicks.
Stiff jab there from Yamaguchi. Jo Marie on the outside here. Jab two from Yamaguchi. Torres needs to start throwing now. Probing with that lead hand. Yamaguchi getting the better of that exchange. Fake there from Jo Marie. Yamaguchi comes forward again. Three punch combination. The jab two followed by the left hook. Nice jab to overhand right there from Yamaguchi.
Torres is kind of leaning back a little bit. After she throws, Mei Yamaguchi will throw a jab. Torres will lean back a little bit with her hands down, and she's kind of open to that overhand right. She got caught with one right there. Torres needs to keep her hands up nice and tight to her chin. Again, I know she wants to defend the takedown if Yamaguchi shoots in, so she might be keeping her hands a little bit low to dig under hooks if Yamaguchi shoots in, but right now Yamaguchi's okay to box.
Yamaguchi playing a kickboxing game here at the moment, Mitch.
Yeah, she says she worked a lot on her hands. She's been, you know, showcasing that tonight. But I would imagine that quite soon she's gonna shoot in for a takedown because she so was able to show such dominance on the ground. There's that knee she was talking about.
Jo Marie Torres, is she holding back a little too much here, Dragon?
I think she's a little bit tentative just because the experience that she had in the last 2 minutes of the first, you know, and you can see Yamaguchi's changing levels quite nicely, so she's threatening that takedown. She's also tapping the lead leg of Torres as well, just to let her know that your leg's right there, I can get it.
Yamaguchi comes in and threads that overhand right again. She is so slick with it. There it is once more for the jaw of Jo Marie Torres.
Torres
might be remaining second round, Mitch.
Maybe throw some uppercuts, because Yamaguchi is getting very close in that distance. If she can touch her legs, an uppercut's there for the taking, just to kind of deter her from changing levels like that and threatening those takedowns.
Outside leg kick at Yuji there, drops it on top of the quads. Does Mei Yamaguchi fakes the left, goes the overhand right. We have seen some succulent striking from the Japanese warrior. And again, cuts that angle to enable the right hand. Drops down to the breadbasket of the Filipina.
Yamaguchi has a clear speed advantage. You can see for every two that she's throwing, Torres is only able to answer back one. Now Torres is getting reactive in her punches. She's waiting for Yamaguchi to attack and initiate the exchange, and then she's reacting. You gotta be proactive in these exchanges. You can't let Mei Yamaguchi build that confidence up.
Needs to put down some points. Does Jo Marie Torres. Under a minute remaining here in the second. There's the big right hand again from Yamaguchi. Then goes to the body.
Torres needs to change things up. Maybe start going back to those leg kicks. She hasn't thrown one leg kick yet this round.
Driving side down there from Mei Yamaguchi. Goes to side control. Yamaguchi looks for the first time to get it. Half guard.
Good job by Torres to get back into half guard. She's probably going to survive this round. But again, it was a nice little punctuation on the 10-minute mark of this match just for Yamaguchi to score that takedown. But again, what that's going to do in the third round, it's going to make Torres even more hesitant to engage in the striking because the way that Yamaguchi was able to slide under those punches and get that takedown was so almost effortless as she slid under there and captured that takedown and slid easily into side control.
One round to go.
Here's Torres putting in some good work in the hands, just barely missing the head there. Good head movement by Yamaguchi, but Yamaguchi ran right into a straight left hand there. Here's Yamaguchi dropping her head, come over the top with the left hook, but then there's that big right hand that touched the jaw.
of Torres. Very good round.
Mitch, I'm going to say, the first three times we saw Jo Marie here in one against Rika, against Mita Tia, against April Asensio, she had so much gusto. She had so much pepper, so much ferocity. But I feel that she lost a bit of that against Priscilla Hurtado in Lumbungol. And again, I don't believe we've seen that same pepper, that same gusto here tonight.
But how do you get that back? How do you get back to the old you that gave you so much success?
But where did it go? How did it go away? That's my question. Because this is not the same Jo Marie Torres we saw against Rika, Mita Tia, or April Asensio. This is the most experienced opponent Jo Marie has ever faced. And you wonder if she's bitten off more than she can chew. And a big right hand like that will make chewing even harder. And again from Mei Yamaguchi.
Jo Marie Torres got a chin, though. If I was getting touched on the chin like that, I might lose a little bit of confidence as well, Michael Civello, because those are big hands. Look how she's changing levels. She's threatening the takedown and coming right over the top with that right hand. Beautiful hand display by Mei Yamaguchi, but a nice, that was kind of a poor takedown attempt right there. Nothing really much behind it. Torres was able to throw it off.
A win for Mei Yamaguchi tonight sends up a flare in the atomweight division once again. But in 2019, VV may be gunning for another tilted gold. This is with the left hand there, Yamaguchi. High up on the balls of her feet here, Mitch.
You can see how she's dipping her head there, though. I'd like to see Torres throw at least one rear uppercut just to let her know that she, oh, there was a knee, though. That was good. As Mei Yamaguchi was coming in, she fired in a knee. That was beautiful by Torres. Torres needs more of that.
You just wonder if Jo Marie has pushed herself a little too much, a little too soon. But then again, you can never underestimate the revelation. We know she's got the weapons to cause an upset. But can she turn it on tonight with 3 minutes 20 remaining? Because Mei Yamaguchi is owning the show here. And what a show it is from the veteran from Tokyo. It began with a full Kata on the stage before her walkout. And the show continues with that high Mawashi Getty roundhouse kick here in the third round. Another flurry from Yamaguchi. She has done everything right tonight besides the first round when she was wearing those leg kicks of Torres. Is she going to plant her here? Torres trying for a guillotine. It is deafening inside the Axiata Arena. These are under the prelims. Can you believe it?
Nice little overhand right there. A little bit of ground and pound from Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi's got to advance her position. She's got 2.5 minutes to work. I'd like to see her get a finish here. After such a dominant performance, she needs a punctuation on this match and get a nice little finish.
Inside the guard of Jo Marie Torres, Mei Yamaguchi has put on a superb show. There's a popping left hand. She postures up and lands it again.
Torres is trying to threaten an armbar here. You can see how she's trapping the right arm of Yamaguchi. She's getting her hands into position. She's thinking about possibly throwing up an armbar.
Yamaguchi postures up. The right hand wants to come down. Jo Marie spoils the party. So she goes to the breadbasket. Then it's the head off the left hand. Feet on hips here, trying to create some space for Jo Marie. Yamaguchi wants to be right on top of her. Where does Jo Marie go now, Mitch?
She's doing a good job. It's a very defensive guard she's throwing. She's not really attacking from the guard, but she was able to keep her feet on the hips of Mei Yamaguchi, and she was able to maintain half guard and not get passed. Now she's just trying to hold on to the head. She might just want to try to hold on and hope that Olivia Kahn stands him up.
1 minute 10 remaining. Some would say 70 seconds. Mei Yamaguchi on top in the full mount of Jo Marie Torres. Now goes side control. Very advantageous position for the Japanese warrior. Knees to the side of the head. Knees to the temple of the Filipina.
Yamaguchi's very active here from side control. Once she tried to pin down that right arm there, you can see Torres tried to defend a knee right there, but she just switches it up and starts going knees to the body.
Yamaguchi, so tenacious. The work rate, the volume, the output, always high. Thoroughly entertaining. This is the way you want to end the year. And time is running out for Jo Marie Torre.
Well, this is tough, though. She's still moving her eyes. See how she's trying to keep getting back into half control? She's still trying to compete. She's still trying to stay in this. Even though she's taking a beating right now from south. From side control. Nice little chest control of the hips. Trying to suck in the legs. Heavy sprawl from Yamaguchi.
Is there one Hail Mary left for Jo Marie Torres? The final 10 seconds. Torres trying to get on top. Yeah. Yamaguchi drives a knee to the shoulder. This is how it ends, and Mei Yamaguchi finishes 2018 on the highest of highs. What tremendous Bushido warrior spirit there between these two martial arts stars.
Yamaguchi just putting in work. Look at that beautiful. Change the levels. Got Torres to drop the hands, overhand right, touching Torres on the chin. And then here's just ground and pound. This is how it all ended. Just Yamaguchi, complete and total domination. Torres was threatening the armbar there, but just didn't have enough to stop the freight train. That was Mei Yamaguchi. What an excellent performance, and what a way for Mei Yamaguchi to end the year.
Tremendous crowd inside the huge Axiata Arena in Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia for ONE Championship's final show of the year. It's Destiny of Champions. Jo Marie Torres, Mei Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi putting on an absolute show over three rounds of dominance. Nice hematoma on the head there, you see, of Jo Marie Torres. Little Christmas gift for her. Let's go to Tom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to our judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the red corner, Mei Yamaguchi.
No doubt about it, Mei Yamaguchi finishes 2018 with a winner's medal around her neck.
Jab early there from Lachkova. High kick from the Russian. Yamaguchi possesses a beautiful overhand right. And with a tall opponent like Lachkova, well, it's tailor-made for that overhand.
Especially because that overhand right is also going to put her in a perfect position to snatch up a single leg as well. So watch for that. Watch her throw that overhand right, drop down, grab that single, turn into a takedown.
Jab right there from Lachkova. An 80% finishing rate for the Russian on a five-bout winning streak tonight. Yamaguchi, who twice fired unsuccessfully for the Atomweight World title, both times came agonizingly close to defeating Angela Lee. We'll see Lee later on tonight shooting for the strawweight world title against Zhong Jinan.
Good takedown defense so far from Lachkova. Able to keep that over-under position, back her up against the cage and separate.
No sign of nerves on Ksenia Lachkova this week around the hotel and all the media engagements. Very comfortable, very relaxed. Comes in with a very good reputation. Just a filling out process at the moment here for both Lachkova and Yamaguchi. Jab two there from Lachkova, sitting behind the reach. How does Mei Yamaguchi overcome the height differential here, Mitch?
She's got to try to get into that range. She's got to try to get into that boxing range first. She can start throwing some of these hands. She's having a hard time dealing with the range of Lachkova, and Lachkova's doing a good job of keeping her at bay with that jab and keeping that distance off. Watch the footwork of Lachkova. Every time you can see Mei Yamaguchi trying to close that distance, Lachkova's moving out and throwing that right hand of hers. She's not throwing any kicks either. She's not giving Mei Yamaguchi a chance to catch any kicks, and she's throwing just hands at this point.
Even though we are sold out here at the Rio Goku Koku Gikan, very quiet. The Japanese are renowned as the most educated martial arts fans in the world. They sit there, they soak it all in, all the techniques, and their deep appreciation for the martial arts in what many people believe and call, amongst myself, the spiritual home of the martial arts. And it's great to have ONE Championship here for the very first time. Single leg lock on from Mei Yamaguchi.
Good job by Mei Yamaguchi to get connected here as she approaches that single leg. She was finally able to duck under some of these punches from Lachkova, close that distance, grab onto that single leg. Look how Lachkova's got that overhook on her right side. She's trying to keep the posture nice and high so Mei Yamaguchi's not able to drop down, change levels, and at least try to circle around and get that double leg. There she goes, trying to get that double leg. Now her hands are almost locked. Lachkova's doing a good job of keeping her legs separated and also using the overhooks to control the posture of Yamaguchi and not enable her to drop down and lock those hands together. Good defense, technically, from Lachkova.
Big hello to all of our Japanese viewers watching tonight on TV Tokyo and Abema TV. Championship, the very first time in Japan. Turn around here from Lachkova, backs Yamaguchi against the fence, crossing elbow from the Russian. Now it's Yamaguchi's turn, nicely done from Vivi.
You can see Yamaguchi has both underhooks. She's got two arms underneath the arms of Lachkova. And Lachkova has such good balance and that reach advantage, height advantage, she's able to stop a lot of the takedown attempts by Yamaguchi. Yamaguchi has to keep her back pressed up against the cage there, or Lachkova would have taken her back. Good job.
And there's the appreciation from the crowd here in Tokyo. Lachkova, who is renowned as a first-round finisher, has not come out as explosively tonight as we've seen her in the past. But this is her step up to the biggest stage of all, the largest martial arts organization in the world, ONE Championship. And she's handling herself very well, I might say, Mitch.
Yeah, she's able to stop a lot of the takedown attempts, and that is a category of our judges' scoring, is takedown defense. And you can see how she's able to do it. You can see just then, Yamaguchi came in with the overhand right, tried to drop her down that single leg, and Lachkova was able to spin her around, press her up against the cage, and now is doing very well inside the clinch.
20 seconds remains. There's the right hand. Now loading it up is Mei Yamaguchi. Traditional martial artist out of Japan against the Pancration World Champion. Takedown there. Final 10 seconds, Yamaguchi on her back. Elbows to the top of the head there from VV Mei Yamaguchi. 1 foot on hips, and that's how the round ends. It's wow. ONE Championship, a new era, live from the Ryogoku Kokugikan in Tokyo, Japan.
Very impressive finish. Look at this, Mei Yamaguchi trying that overhand right. Look at that, she's able to keep her shoulder nice and tight to her chin and was able to deflect a lot of that power coming from Mei. But then, here in the exchange, Mei Yamaguchi lands that short left hand, but Lachkova, the towering kickboxer, was able to throw that overhand right and touch Yamaguchi on the chin. But more significantly, Lachkova was able to score a big takedown at the very end of that round and end the round in a very dominant position. Now, we don't score round by round, but at the first 5 minutes, Lachkova is looking very sharp in all the different areas.
We're ready to roll. Second round of three between Ksenia Lachkova and VV Mei Yamaguchi. A magnificent scene inside this incredible building. The Kokugikan, renowned as the Sumo Arena here in Japan. Its hallowed hallways have been walked by some incredible martial arts champions. Tonight, many of them on display, over 130 martial arts world champions in ONE Championship. Yamaguchi comes out firing with the right hand. Inside leg kick missed the target, counter there from Lachkova.
This is what Mei Yamaguchi has to do. She has to make this dirty. She can't allow Lachkova to stand at her range and touch her up with those hands. She's got to get close. She's got to make it dirty. Throw that right hand. That's it. Get nice and tight now. How can she do it? She's got to change levels, drop down, tack that single leg. Good defense from Lachkova. The way she's able to utilize these overhooks to control the position of Yamaguchi is very impressive. Yamaguchi is incredibly strong inside the clinch. Again, she's a judo black belt.
Inside leg there, drops down, locks onto a single leg. Does Yamaguchi, can she affect the takedown? Can she get the Russian on her back? It was Yamaguchi who was on her back at the end of the opening round. But as Mitch said, Lachkova doing a lot right so far here tonight.
See, she's utilizing that underhook to keep Mei Yamaguchi posture nice and high and keep it from dropping down. She's even trying to lace these legs and go for the takedown. Watch Koko might have grabbed the takedown there. Might have stopped the takedown by grabbing the fence, but eventually Yamaguchi was able to get it.
Close guard from Ksenia Luchkova. 3:20 remains. Second round of three. Throws that close guard up a little higher now, does Luchkova. Let's see if May can posture up, break it open, land some ground and pound. Postures up now, just May, the hands are locked up for the moment. Tries to get the right hand free, wants a hammer fist strike. And again, close guard, opens it, closes it again, does Luchkova.
You see Luchkova's trying to pin down one of these arms, look for an armbar. Yep, there she goes, throw the hips up. And as we see, this is a big high on the arm. You can see the elbow is almost out. She might be able to pop it out, but she's got to, you know, because of the length of Luchkova, she's able to attack a lot of these positions.
Out of that predicament is Mei Yamaguchi. Still top position here for the Japanese martial artist. Good right hand there for Yamaguchi. Smack back on the schnoz of Luchkova, then goes to the body.
Luchkova's got a very active guard. You can see her. She's always trying to look for something. She's trying to pin down these arms, trying to lock one of those arms into place so she can start throwing those legs up.
Luchkova eats another right hand.
Good job from Mei Yamaguchi to control that top position. Not putting herself in any big danger, but she is starting to land some ground and pound as well.
Where does Luchkova go from here, Dragon?
I'd like to see Luchkova keep attacking this arm like this. She's trying to pin down that arm like that, and she's going to try to go try to swing one of these legs over and attack another arm bar again. Mei Yamaguchi is not going to make a mistake by putting her hands on the ground and give Luchkova the ability to shoot a triangle. But what we are seeing is I'd like to see Luchkova just separate here, put the feet on the hips of Mei Yamaguchi and start to push her away. But she keeps hunting for that arm bar.
Hammer fist there from Yamaguchi from inside the close guard of Luchkova. Ooh, goes to the bread basket. One up to the chest there from Yamaguchi. Three levels in three punches there from Mei Yamaguchi. 1:15 remains. Little peppering shots on the side of the jaw there from Mei. And Luchkova looks to clamp towards her corner. They're giving her instructions here, the Russian.
Skova's looking for the finish. She's trying to throw those legs up. See how high her guard is? She's looking for this, but Mei Yamaguchi's not making really any mistakes to give Luchkova the opportunity to throw that submission in.
Mei Yamaguchi, one of six Japanese competitors on tonight's card. Can she give Team Japan a great start here inside the Rio Goku Koku Gigan for ONE Championship, a new era? Hiroki Akimoto up next, Senzo Akeda later on. Of course, Ken Hasegawa still coming. Aoki. So Yuya Wakamatsu against Demetrius Johnson. Big lineup, big night for Japan. Two punches, then one to the bread basket from Mei Yamaguchi. We do have another Russian on the card too later on, in the form of Timofey Nastukin taking on Eddie Alvarez. Don't sleep on Nastukin. When he goes beast mode, Eddie Alvarez had better keep his hands up.
Good ground and pound coming from Mei Yamaguchi. Very calculated strategy here on the ground. She's picking her shots, and she's doing just enough work to stop the stand-up from Kemp Chang. Here's that takedown that she was finally able to get. Beautiful double leg as she's able to turn off the cage.
ONE Championship, a new era in Tokyo, Japan. Third and final round here between Mei Yamaguchi and Ksenia Luchkova. How do you see it so far, Dragon?
It's pretty close at this point. There was a lot of effective ground and pound coming from Yamaguchi. I think at this point, it's going to come down to these last 5 minutes on who can turn it up the most and clinch this victory in one of the biggest cards in history.
Jab two there from Luchkova. Seemed to be a bit more gusto from Yamaguchi coming out of her corner. Can she get on the inside of the reach of Luchkova? Maybe find range with that overhand right. There it is. Just caught the shoulder though, the lead shoulder of the Russian.
See, watch how Luchkova's stance is. She's always bringing her left shoulder nice and close to her chin, and that's been able to deflect a lot of the shots from Yamaguchi.
Completely different builds between these two martial artists. Ooh, counter right hand there from Yamaguchi. Throws the right down the corridor again.
And that right hand was able to connect because Lachkova switched to southpaw and it opened her up for that shot.
Yamaguchi wants to drop down, see if she can take Lachkova onto her back. Good right down the court. Once more there from Yamaguchi. Crowd response to it. Now starting the final range with the right hand. There's a double leg from Yamaguchi on the takedown. I love it. Inside the Rio Goku Kokugigan.
Now Yamaguchi's starting to feel the moment, and she's realizing that this is still her match to get. And she's able to do a lot of good work here in the third round.
Yamaguchi.
Beautiful right hands landed by Yamaguchi.
Top position here as she ended out the previous round. Little hammer fist there from Yamaguchi. Locking down the wrists is Lachkova. Another one there to the orbital. 3 minutes and five remains. Third and final round, Russia versus Japan, as Lachkova tries to lock on for an arm.
Triangle. There it is.
For Russia.
Finally able to get it. She was looking for it the entire time, but it looks like Yamaguchi is able to use Lachkova's attempt at a triangle to get the pass, and now sits inside side control.
Over the shot of the head. And this crowd sold out already here in San Rio. Goku Kokugigan is loving it every time Yamaguchi lands.
Man, typically, Michael, the Japanese crowds are so quiet, but even their sense of the moment, the magnitude of this card, and they're getting into it.
Since this card was announced, I believe it was last October, the buzz has been incredible. And over the last week, it has reached fever pitch here in Tokyo.
Nice ground and pound still coming from VV Mei Yamaguchi. Now she's sitting in half guard, and Lachkova's got to do something to get back up. She's got about 2 minutes to work. Yamaguchi's got heavy top pressure at this point. Now she's trying to pin her left leg on the thigh of Lachkova, and what she's going to try to do is try to slide her right leg through the half guard just like that and sit into mount and take the back possibly here of Lachkova looking for an armbar.
Armbar for VV Mei Yamaguchi. Is she going to tap her out? In the third and final round, yes, she does. It's a win for Yamaguchi. It's a win for Japan. It's an historic win. Yamaguchi brings the house down in the Rio Goku Kokugigan.
Wow, that was beautiful. Mei Yamaguchi was able to find the finish. It didn't happen in the first, but it eventually happened in the third. Beautiful finish, submission victory for VV Mei Yamaguchi in her hometown of Tokyo, Japan. Inside the guard. Look at this. Ducks under the punches coming from Lachkova. Chases down the double leg. And then she was able to slide through the guard. There she has landed a big knee to soften Lachkova up. Inside control. She passed into mount. You can see Lachkova extending the arms, gift wrapping the arm bar. Mei Yamaguchi takes it home like Christmas and gets the finish. Look at this adjustment. There's the thumb. Watch the thumb. The thumb has to stay up. There's no place for Lachkova to go except to tap her way out. Beautiful win from Mei Yamaguchi.
Let's go to Tom Lau to make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Kent Chang, has called a stop to this contest after 3 minutes and 18 seconds in the third and final round for your winner by way of armbar, Mei Yamaguchi!
There are six Japanese warriors on tonight's card. Yamaguchi is the first, Aoki will be the final, and it's one from one for Team Japan in Tokyo.